I'm mixing up a batch of potatoes to make potato lefses. I think I told you how I get my potatoes, didn't I? I cooked up 10 pounds with salt, put them through the ricer. Also, when you're done ricing them, you add 2 sticks of butter, which would be 1 cup of butter, and 1 cup of half and half. If you happen to not have half and half, you can use evaporated milk. And then if you put the sticks of butter in while you're ricing the potatoes and they're still hot, it'll just melt down into the potatoes real nice. And then you can add in the 1 cup of milk when you're done ricing, and then just mix it up well. And that's when you get this mixture here.
So you're doing 3 cups to a batch.
3 cups to a batch. And these potatoes are nice and cool now. As you can see, they're getting kind of lumpy. But the dough does mix up better and it rolls out better once the potatoes are cooled. Three cups of potato mixture, 1 teaspoon of salt, and 1 tablespoon of sugar. And then you add 3/4 cup of flour. The barrel is about empty. I'm going to be lucky to...
You made it.
Just make it. I thought I had another bag of flour, and I did not.
So you finish up kneading the dough by hand?
Yes. And then you'll be able to tell once it has mixed together nice and is all of the same consistency. You don't have any flour or small pieces like that rolling around. It's all mixed together. There, it's starting to come together. To show the dough who's in charge.
Right.
The dough always wants to be. But if you keep at it, eventually you'll get a nice, smooth roll of dough.
And this is actually, everything here is cooked now except for the flour, right?
Right. We'll do our measuring again. If you can't estimate...
No eggs in this at all.
No. If you're not any good at estimating, then you get out your ruler and you measure it with a ruler. So here's half. That makes 12. This makes 12. 1, 2, 3, yes, 24. 12 on each half. Excuse me. And then you just cut off. Well, now that might be a little bit big, so, and I cut into the next one. And then you have to roll it, try to get it into a good ball so that if you don't, see, those areas will crack as you're rolling. Be perfect. So we're going to move over here, and it sure helps if you have one of these boards. I'll show you at the bottom is a Masonite board. You can get them at most Norwegian shops. I buy mine down at Story City. They have a hardware store that sells Norwegian things. North Story City is a nice little Norwegian town. You have to have a pastry cloth over the board, and that helps keep from sticking so bad, so that your potato lefses don't stick. Now see how it wants to pop open, but as you go along, hopefully it'll come out of that. I'll make Clayton edit out the bad ones. Some of them are shaped like the United States or Texas, as my husband so nicely points out to everyone. And here, if you don't have enough flour down, you can end up getting into trouble. I like my edges to be smoother, but I'm just starting this new batch, so we'll go with what we have for now.
Okay, and what is this that you put that on?
That's a Lefse griddle. This griddle has a Teflon coating, and I like that better than the just bare metal ones. It seems they don't stick so bad.
Better than the aluminum?
Right.
And then you put a light layer of flour on your board?
Yes, you got to keep the board floured. And here again, that's why I like to use only 3/4 of a cup of flour in the recipe, because then I can have a little more flour here and it won't hurt a thing because I only used 3/4 of a cup. That's not quite ready to turn yet. And you just have to learn to feel what feels right to you. You can make your lefses larger, you can make them smaller, thicker, thinner. Sometimes my griddle doesn't cook real evenly. You have to turn it around. But I'll tell you what, when they go to eat them, they don't care if they're perfectly round or not. You just put a nice layer of butter and sugar and roll it up. They don't care what they look like.
And this is my job to turn them.
Yeah. I can do it by myself, but it takes quite a bit longer if you don't have somebody to help you turn them. Because you can't keep rolling, you have to keep watching.
And these are turners that I made out of black ash, mostly just with a table saw and a table belt sander. Just kind of make I like these a lot better than the ones that are just tapered on the end. These are tapered all the way around. Now tell me about the cover that you have on your...
On the rolling pin?
Rolling pin, yes.
That's called a sock. A rolling pin sock. And you wouldn't have to have it, but I'll tell you what, it really helps to keep the dough from sticking.
And you put flour on it too, right?
I just, at the beginning when I start, I put flour all over it like this. And then periodically I just might run it over like this. I don't flour it every time. If your dough starts to stick to the rolling pin sock, then you know it's time to add some flour. This one's getting a little nicer shaped. Doesn't have scalloped edges quite so bad, but that's part of the fun of making potato lefses. You never know what you're going to have. The griddles are expensive, the lefse griddles that we're cooking the lefses on. Now see, that one could be a little bit browner. I don't like them quite that light. You can leave that one for now, but
okay.
The griddles are rather expensive. They cost at least $100, and sometimes the element, which is this, will burn out, and you can buy them separately. You don't have to buy the whole unit, but unfortunately the elements are what cost the money. And so if you get a replacement element, it costs you about $50 to $75. So most of the time you think, well, you might as well just buy the whole new thing. I've had trouble. I haven't seen any of the griddles with the Teflon coating for a while, and so I just as soon buy the element for maybe $15 or $20 less than the whole new unit, because I've had trouble finding the Teflon coated ones. Rolling out the potato lefses is kind of like rolling out cringla. Either you have a feel for it or you don't. And sometimes it's hard for somebody new that's trying to learn how to do it. You just don't give up. If you want to make them, and don't think they all have to be perfect, because they aren't. Underneath the tea towel, then I move them over to the, we're using the top of my stove, and then put a tea towel plus plastic over the top, and that's to steam them, to make them nice and soft.
And we'll show that in a minute here. And I see you've got the wooden cutting board
I'm trying to protect,
I made underneath it to
protect the countertop.
Right, keep
the
heat
towel
from
under that.
Then we take them off the griddle and put them onto a towel, just on a little stool here, and then you fold the cloth back up over it to keep all the heat in. At this point, you want them to stay hot.
Not hot, warm.
Just their own warm.
Underneath here, sometimes the potato lefse wants to stick right in the middle. And if it does, just be careful and bring it up as carefully as you can. Try not to tear it any bigger. And most of the time, you can just repair it with a stick. I'll tear that one apart, and then I'll leave that up to Clayton to show you how to repair it.
Oh, you did it too much.
Pardon?
You made too big of a hole.
Oh, no, I'll do it. I'll fix it then.
Okay, so if there's a hole, you can just fix it right up.
You can just seal it right together.
All right.
And it might show up a little bit, but not too bad.
And then we keep a dish towel here too, just to wipe off the griddle now and then. Keeps the extra flour off of there from, keeps it from burning.
You might want to put a sheet or something down. I have rugs down here on the floor because I just don't want all of that flour going right onto the floor. These have cooled now for about a half an hour with the wax paper over the top to let them cool down. And so I've already counted these now. There's 12 here. And so once you get them on the plate, you put them in a plastic bag. I like to use these nice, big, thick, gallon-sized freezer bags. They're extra thick. And just scoot it in there. You can mark them if you want to. We usually eat ours up before they're all marked. And as you can see, we've got 4 dozen all done up here. I've got a couple more dozen on the stove ready to be bagged. These are the ones that are cooling.
And so how cool do you let them get? Are they just...
Let them get cool to the touch. So they don't feel so warm.
Yeah, anymore. They're not real... warm.
They're just cooling down now. They've been steamed already.
Okay.
I need one more on there to make a dozen.
And that's about the brownness that you like, is just...
Yeah, this one got a little brown like on the bottom, but you know, it's not burned. And it still tastes very good. It doesn't matter if they're a little more brown.
Don't have to be perfectly even.
No. And when I was a young girl, we did not have electric or gas stoves. All we had was an old cook stove. And so we would put cobs in the cook stove, and then we would cook right on top of the stove top. And so it's a real treat to have a nice lefse griddle. Actually, it's a pancake or egg, and you can use the griddle for whatever you want to. I just save mine exclusively for the lefses because I don't want it to get grease cooked on to it and then affect the quality of the lefse.
Okay. Thank you.
My recipe is 3 cups of riced or mashed potatoes, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 tablespoon of sugar, and 3/4 to 1 cup of flour. I always use 3/4 cup because then I can add a little more flour when I'm rolling them out. So this is the salt. Sugar, and I'm about out of flour, but I'm going to use, this is 1/4 cup, and I'm going to fill it 3 times for 3/4 of a cup of flour. And then you need to mix this all together. It's sort of like for pie dough.